Hello and welcome back to the University of Georgia Sailing Channel. My name is Allison, and today we're talking about lifts and headers, what they are and what to do when they happen. So when we're sailing, we deal with two properties of wind. We deal with direction and we deal with velocity. The wind velocity changes in the form of puffs and lulls. So puffs are a lot of wind and lulls are less wind. And then our wind will change direction in the form of shifts. And each shift can either be defined as a lift or a header. So by definition, a lift is a wind shift to the stern of a boat, and a header is a wind shift to the bow of the boat. A lift will allow a boat to head closer to what used to be the wind direction, and the header will force a boat to head away from what used to be the wind direction. So let's draw that out and see what that looks like. All right, this is our original wind direction, what we're going to be starting with. And first we're going to depict a lift. So by definition, a lift is a shift of the wind to the stern. So that means that our wind is now kind of coming from this direction. So it was here, and it's shifting to come over the stern a little bit. So if we look at where our new wind direction is coming from, that now puts our boat at a beam reach. Go watch our points of sail video if you don't know what that is. But we're looking to sail close hauled. So this wind direction will now allow the boat to point up to something like this to match the new direction. And vice versa, if you have a wind shift to the bow, that means that the original wind is going to shift this way. It's going to force the boat to turn away from the wind, because now this would be an irons, right? Irons means that the sail is luffing. The boat is going to be forced to head away from the new wind. Okay, so let's talk about how to recognize these changes in wind direction. When you get a lift, the signs that the boat gives you are a lot less apparent than what happens when you get a header. There are telltales on your jib, which are little pieces of yarn that are put on by a little sticker, positioned two or three places up the front of the jib, and they're on either side, and they tell you how wind is moving over the sail. So if both telltales on either side are flying straight back, that means that there's equal flow going on each side of the sail. Now, if you get a wind shift and it shifts to the stern, so that means you get a lift, your leeward telltale is going to flap, and you always head away from whichever telltale is flapping to get the flow back on the telltale to make it fly straight. So you know you'll get a lift if your leeward telltale starts luffing. And by all means, you always want to make sure that the leeward telltale is happy, so you want to adjust your boat position to get that flying straight back again. So conversely, if you get a header, the windward telltale is going to luff if it's just a little bit of a header. In 420 and FJ sailing, the optimal telltale position is when the leeward telltale is flying straight back and when the windward telltale is up just a little bit, so when you're just kind of on the verge of pinching. But if your windward telltale starts going crazy, that is a good indication that if you do not change something soon, you will either stay in a really pinched tack that's close to the wind, or your sail is getting ready to luff. If you get a big enough header, it will bypass a luffing windward telltale and it will go straight to the sail luffing. And in which case you have two options. You can either tack away or you can bear down and stay on the same tack that you're on. Now I want to look at the relationship between headers and lifts. So this is our original wind direction. If we get a shift to the bow of the boat, and it's now coming like this. Remember we said it was going to force the boat to head away. But let's say we have a boat on the opposite tack, and this wind shift to this boat is a shift to the bow, but to this boat is a shift to the stern. So for this boat, they're getting a header, but for this boat, they're getting a lift. So whatever you get, whether it be a lift or a header, there's always the opposite on the other tack. So if you get a lift, you probably don't want to tack on the lift. If you get a header, you most likely want to tack on a header to go find the lift somewhere else. That is all I have for lifts and headers. Please let me know in the comments down below if you have any questions, if you want to see videos on other topics, or if you just want to chat. I'm here. If you need a friend. thank you so much for watching, and please check out our other videos on this channel, and subscribe if you feel so inclined, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.